morning all of you. In the last session I had completed the desirable properties of aggregates and tests on aggregates. Okay, in today's session I'll move on to the next topic, that is binders. Okay, usually based on the binder content itself, okay, the pavement was classified into two types. Basically, or based on the structural performance also, the pavement is classified into two types. Okay, the one that is flexible pavement, another one that is rigid pavement. Okay, the flexible pavement is the bituminous pavement, the blacked up surface pavements, you know that, no? That is the bituminous pavements are called flexible pavements, and the concrete pavements are called rigid pavements. Okay, in the flexible pavement, they are going to use bitumen as a binder. Bitumen as a binder, whereas in the rigid pavement, they are going to use cement as a binder. They are going to use cement as a binder. These based on the binder content, okay, and also based on the structural performance of the pavement was classified into two types, flexible pavement and rigid pavement. Okay, and for the flexible pavement, you don't use the binder, it is a building. Okay, in earlier days, they are going to use tar as a binder for the flexible pavement, but nowadays, the tar is not in use. The tar is not in use. Is it clear? Then the question is, what is the difference between tar and bitumen? What is the difference between tar and bitumen? It's very important. Okay? It is a bitumen and next it is a tar. Okay? Both bitumen and tar blackish in color. Is it clear? But for the bitumen, there is a slight greenish shade, whereas tar is completely dark in color. Okay, if you consider the color of the material, okay, the bitumen it is black in color with greenish shade. Okay, whereas in tar, black in color, is completely dark. Okay, because the tar is completely dark in color because the tar is contained high carbon content compared to bitumen. Okay, in the bitumen, carbon content is medium, and whereas in tar, carbon content is high. Carbon content is high. Is it clear? Okay, and your bitumen is more adhesive than tar. Okay, more adhesive than tar. Okay, whereas tar less adhesive. What do you mean by adhesive? The attractive force between the different kind of particles, that adhesive property, the adhesive property. Okay, and okay, your bitumen is less temperature susceptible. Okay, what do you mean temperature susceptibility? Means for high temperature, the material becomes too soft, and for low temperatures, the material becomes too brittle. That is called the temperature susceptibility. Your bitumen having less temperature susceptibility, whereas tar is having more temperature susceptibility. Okay? Less temperature or you can say low temperature, low temperature susceptibility, whereas tar is more temperature susceptible. Okay, means the tar is for high temperatures easily too soft, and for low temperatures it easily too brittle. Okay, at high temperatures easily melted and at low temperatures easily brittle. Is it clear? That is the temperature susceptibility. Okay, bitumen is having less temperature susceptibility, we can say low temperature susceptibility, whereas tar is having more temperature susceptibility. Is it clear? And the major point, your bitumen is obtained from the fractional distillation of crude petroleum, whereas the tar is obtained from the destructive distillation of coal or wood. Is it clear? Number 5. Okay, obtained from fractional distillation of crude petroleum, fractional distillation of crude petroleum, whereas your tar obtained from destructive distillation of coal or wood. Obtained from destructive distillation of coal or wood. Is it clear? Means the bitumen is obtained from the fractional distillation of crude petroleum, whereas the tar is obtained from the destructive distillation of coal or wood. Is it clear? And the next step is number 6. Your bitumen is completely soluble in carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride, that is CS2 and CCl4, whereas your tar is soluble in toluene. Is it clear? Completely soluble in CS2 and CCl4, that is carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride, whereas the tar is completely soluble in toluene. Completely soluble in toluene. Chemical compound. Toluene is a chemical compound. Okay, and the bitumen having a specific gravity ranges from 0.98 to 1.03. Specific gravity ranges from 0.98 to 1.03, whereas tar specific gravity ranges from 1.1 to 1.25. 1.1 to 1.25. Is it clear? This is regarding the differentiate between your tar and bitumen. It's very important. Okay? And people till now, they're used to call a bitumen as a tar. Okay? In the road construction, you may heard that the black pepper pavement construction, while constructing the bituminous pavements, the people used to call it as a tar, tar, tar. It is not a tar. Okay? It is a bitumen. It is a bitumen. Is it clear? Okay? This is regarding the bitumen and tar. Okay? Next, I'll move on to the types of bitumen. Types of bitumen. Okay, basically there are three types of bitumen are used now. Okay, the first one it is cut back bitumen. Second one it is emulsion bitumen or bitumen emulsion. Emulsion bitumen or you can also call as bitumen emulsion. Third one it is modified binders. Modified binders. Is it clear? Okay. Okay. While constructing the pavement, okay, particularly in the black tarred surface, in the bituminous pavement construction, what they want to do is to reduce the viscosity of the bitumen, they want to heat the bitumen prior to mixing. Means before mixing with aggregates, they want to heat the bitumen to reduce the viscosity. But, okay, in the cut back bitumen, what they want to do is whatever the bitumen which is in the solid form, for that bitumen they want to add some solvents. They want to add some solvents to reduce the viscosity. Then the resultant bitumen is called cutback bitumen. Means the cutback bitumen is in viscous liquid form. The cutback bitumen is in viscous liquid form. Means for the solid form of bitumen, they want to add some solvents, usually like kerosene, naphtha and diesel. Kerosene, naphtha, diesel, they want to add to the solid form of the bitumen, then the viscosity of those solid form of bitumen will be reduces and it becomes in the viscous liquid form. Okay, then the resulting bitumen is called the cutback bitumen. Is it clear? Okay, cutback bitumen. Okay, the cutback bitumen is the form of bitumen in the form in the state of viscous liquid, and the solvents like naphtha, kerosene and diesel will add it to the solid form of the bitumen to get the cutback bitumen. Is it clear? Means compared to your natural bitumen, the cutback bitumen having low viscosity. Means the viscosity of the bitumen is reduced by adding a suitable solvents. Okay, the resultant bitumen is called cutback bitumen. Is it clear? And usually the cutback bitumen will be preferred in the cold climate construction of pavements. Okay, in the cold climate construction of pavements, the two of bituminous pavements, they are going to prefer the cutback bitumen. Is it clear? Okay, basically there are three types of cutback bitumen. Okay, the first one it is rapid curing, RC, and second one it is medium curing, MC, and third one it is slow curing, SC. Okay, there are three types of cutback bitumen: rapid curing RC, medium curing MC, slow curing SC. Is it clear? Okay, the rapid curing cutback bitumen will be used in surface dressing work. We use in surface dressing work. Okay, whereas medium curing bitumen, that to the medium curing cutback bitumen, they are going to use in pre-mix. They are going use in pre-mix, okay, when the fine aggregate content is less, means the aggregate size less than 4.75 mm, okay. If the type of aggregate, means the fine aggregate content is less, then they won't use the medium curing cutback bitumen in the pre-mix. Pre-mix means what? That is mix in the plant itself. Okay, when the fine aggregate content is less, okay, in that case they won't use a medium curing bitumen, okay, in the pre-mix. Okay, the slow curing bitumen is also used in the pre-mix. Mix in the plant. Is it clear? And the fine aggregate contents is more. Okay, means the abundant quantity of fine aggregate is there in the dry mix of aggregates. In that case, they won't use the slow curing bitumen. Okay, if the fine aggregate is less, they won't use the medium curing cutback bitumen. Whereas the fine aggregate is more in the aggregate mix, then they won't use the slow curing cutback bitumen. And the cutback bitumen may or may not requires heat before usage, means before application of the cutback bitumen, okay, you may subject it to heat or you may not subject it to heat for the cutback bitumen. Means what will happen, whatever the solvents you are going to add for the bitumen to reduce the viscosity, no? And those solvents will be evaporating while applying in the road surface. Okay, then the cutback bitumen starts binding with the aggregates. Means once you apply the cutback bitumen on the road surface, whatever the solvents is there in the cutback bitumen, those solvents will be evaporating. Then the resultant bitumen will be binding with the aggregates. Is it clear? Okay, this is regarding the cutback bitumen. Is it clear? Next is bitumen emulsion or emulsion bitumen. Bitumen emulsion. Okay, it is a liquid form of bitumen, and the bitumen emulsion does not require any heat before the application. Means the bitumen emulsion does not require heat before the application on the road surface. Is it clear? Okay, the bitumen emulsion is the type of bitumen, okay, it is in finely divided condition and it is suspended in aqueous medium like water by a suitable stabilizing material. Is it clear? Means the bitumen in finely divided condition is suspended in water by stabilizing suitable material, that is called bitumen emulsion. Okay, usually if you consider the bitumen emulsion container of about 200 liter capacity, okay, if you consider this, this is the container of bitumen emulsion of 200 liter capacity, okay, out of this container total volume, the 70% is your bitumen emulsion and remaining 30% it is your water. Okay, 70% of bitumen and 30% of water. Means they are going to suspend the liquid form of bitumen or the bitumen which is in a finely divided condition in a water. In a water. Means if you consider 200 liter capacity drum, okay, 140 liter is your bitumen and 60 liter is your water. Okay, and what will happen is while applying the bitumen emulsion on the road surface, the water starts evaporating, then your bitumen emulsion starts binding with the aggregates. Your bitumen emulsion starts binding with the aggregates. Is it clear? Okay, and as your cutback bitumen, okay, in the same manner, your bitumen emulsion also, there are three types. Okay, there are three types of bitumen emulsion. Okay, setting RS. Okay, and second one it is medium setting MS, and third one it is slow setting SS. Okay, there are three pairs of bitumen emulsion: rapid setting RS, medium setting MS, slow setting SS. Okay, and the rapid setting bitumen emulsion is used in surface dressing work. Surface dressing work. Okay, and the medium setting and the slow setting will be used as a tack coat, prime coat, and seal coats, and also used in the premix. Okay, your rapid setting bitumen emulsion used in the what that? In the surface dressing work, and medium setting and slow setting the bitumen emulsion used in the premix of aggregates. Premix with the aggregates. Okay, this is regarding the bitumen emulsion and cutback bitumen. And usually the bitumen is also classified, okay, anionic type of emulsion, cationic type of emulsion, and ionic type of emulsion. Anionic type of emulsion means it is a negatively charged particles, cationic emulsion means positively charged particles, and ionic type of emulsion means is a neutral particles. Okay, in India we are going to use a cationic type of emulsion, that is positively charged emulsion we are going to use. Is it clear? This is types of bitumen emulsion, but the bitumen emulsion is also classified in three groups. What are those? Anionic type of emulsion, cationic type of emulsion, and ionic type of emulsion. Anionic means negatively charged, cationic means positively charged, and ionic type means is a neutral. Okay, in India we want to prefer a cationic type of emulsion. Is it clear? Okay, this is regarding the cutback bitumen and emulsion bitumen. There is one more type of bitumen, that is modifier binders. Modified binders. Okay. Modified binders are modified bitumen, we can say. Modified binders are modified bitumen. Okay. The bitumen for which they are going to add some modifiers to change some of the properties of bitumen, the resultant bitumen is called modified bitumen. Okay, for the bitumen they are going to add some modifiers to modify the properties of bitumen, the resultant bitumen is called modified bitumen. Okay, and usually they are going to use two types of modifiers. One it is polymers, another one is rubber. Okay, usually they want to use two types of modifiers. One it is polymers, another one it is rubber. Is it clear? Okay, and if you use a polymers to modify the bitumen properties, then resultant bitumen is called PMB. Okay, polymer modified bitumen. And if they use the rubber to modify the properties of bitumen, then the resultant bitumen is called RMB. Rubber modified bitumen. Is it clear? Usually the polymers they won't use in the modified binders. Okay, SBS. Okay, stearine butadiene stearine. SBS polymers. Okay, is one of the most preferable polymers for the modifying the properties of bitumen. SBS, stearine butadiene stearine. Okay, means if they use the polymers to modify the bitumen, the resultant bitumen is called polymer modified bitumen. And if they use the rubber to modify the properties of bitumen, then the resultant bitumen is called rubber modified bitumen, that is RMB. Is it clear? And in the polymers also, there are two types of polymers. Okay, in the polymers also, there are two types of polymers. One it is elastomeric polymers and another one is plastomeric polymers. One is elastomeric polymers, another one is plastomeric polymers. And in the rubber also, there are two types of rubbers they want to use. One it is natural rubber, another one it is crumbled rubber. Is it clear? Means there are two types of polymers they want to use in the bitumen to modify the properties. Okay, there are, that is elastomeric polymers, plastomeric polymers. Okay, then if you use the elastomeric polymers to modify the properties of bitumen, then the resultant bitumen is called PMB E type. That is polymer modified bitumen of elastomeric type. Then if they use the plastomeric polymers to modify the properties of bitumen, then the resultant bitumen is called PMB P type. That is polymer modified bitumen of plastomeric type. Plastomeric type. Okay? And if they use the natural rubber to modify the properties of bitumen, then it is called NRMB. This natural rubber modified bitumen, NRMB. Natural rubber modified bitumen. Then if you use the crumbled rubber, okay, the crumbled rubber is the powder form of waste tire. Crumbled rubber is the powder form of waste tire. Is it clear? If they use the crumbled rubber to modify the properties of bitumen, then the resultant bitumen is called CRMB. Crumbled rubber modified bitumen. NRMB is a natural rubber modified bitumen used in the natural rubber obtained from some trees, the rubber trees. Okay, whereas the crumbled rubber is the powder form of waste tire. Okay, then the resultant bitumen is called CRMB, crumbled rubber modified bitumen. Okay, this is regarding the type of bitumen, that is cutback bitumen, emulsion bitumen and modified binders. After that, the cutback bitumen and emulsion bitumen is very important. Okay, the mass explain the cutback bitumen or emulsion bitumen, or write a shortcut on bitumen emulsion and cutback bitumen is very important. Is it clear? Okay. Next it is tests on bitumen. Test on bitumen. Okay. There are about 11 tests conducted on a bitumen. Okay. Those are, number one, it is penetration test. Second one it is ductility test. Third one it is softening point test. Fourth one, viscosity test. Fifth one it is float test. Sixth one, specific gravity test. Okay. Seventh one it is flash and fire point test. Next, solubility test. Next, it is spot test. Tenth one, it is loss
on eating test, loss on eating test. 11th one it is water content test. Water content test. Okay, the first one is penetration test, next ductility, softening point test, viscosity test, float test, specific gravity test, flash and fire point test, solubility test, spot test, loss and heating test and water content test. Okay, the penetration test is conducted on the bitumen to test the hardness and softness of the bitumen. To test the hardness and softness of the bitumen. Okay, in earlier days, the penetration test is used to classify the grades of bitumen. In earlier days, it is PG grade of bitumen. Nowadays, it is VG, viscosity grade. Okay, in earlier days, PG grade of 30 by 40, 50 by 70, 80 by 100. That is penetration grades of bitumen. Okay, 30 40 indicates the bitumen whose penetration value from 30 to 40. Okay, 80 by 100 bitumen indicates the bitumen whose penetration value from 80 to 100. Is it clear? Okay, in earlier days the penetration test is used to classify the grades of bitumen. Nowadays the penetration is not in use for classification of grades of bitumen, but the penetration test is conducted on bitumen to test the hardness and softness of the bitumen. We can call this consistency of the bitumen. To know the consistency of the bitumen, we are going to conduct the penetration test. Is it clear? Usually the penetration value will be expressed in 1/10 of mm, because the penetration ring will be graduated in 1/10 of mm. Okay, there is a standard needle of 1 mm square. That standard needle will be penetrate into the bitumen sample for a 5 seconds. Okay, then note on the penetration, that is your penetration value. Okay, the standard needle, for that they are going to attach the 100 gram weight. Okay, that standard needle will penetrate into this specimen for about 5 seconds. Okay, then record the penetration value. Okay, usually average of the 3 penetration values should be recorded as the penetration value of the bitumen. Is it clear? Means to test the hardness and softness of the bitumen, we are going to conduct the penetration test. Next is ductility test. Using ductility machine, we are going to conduct the ductility test, and you are using a penetrometer, you are going to conduct the penetration test, bitumen penetrometer, and using ductility machine you are going to conduct the ductility test. The ductility test is conducted to test the adhesive property of the bitumen, or to test the ability of stretch. To test the ability of stretch. Usually the ductility value will be recorded in terms of centimeter. Okay, for the bitumen which is used in the road construction, the ductility value from 50 to 75 cm is preferable. Is it clear? The ductility test is conducted by using a ductility machine to test the adhesive property of the bitumen or ability of stretch of bitumen, and usually the ductility value is expressed in terms of centimeter. Okay, next is softening point. Okay, the softening point test is conducted by using ring and ball operators. Okay, and the softening point test is conducted to test the softening point of bitumen. Means to know the softening point of bitumen, they are going to conduct the test called softening point test by using ring and ball operators. Then what do you mean by softening point? Softening point is the temperature at which the bitumen attains a particular degree of softening. Means at what temperature the bitumen becomes softer, that we have to record in softening point test. Is it clear? Next, viscosity test. Next it is viscosity test. What do you mean viscosity? Viscosity is the measure of resistance to flow. Viscosity is the measure of resistance to flow. Okay, usually the viscosity will be expressed in terms of seconds. Okay, for the 50 ml flow of bitumen, okay, how much seconds it is took? Okay, the basic principle of viscosity test is, for the 50 ml flow of bitumen, what is the time taken? Okay, that will be expressed in seconds as the viscosity value.
Okay, usually we are going to use the tar viscometer to determine the viscosity of cutback binders and emulsion binders and tar. Whereas for the normal bitumen, they are going to use viscosity bath to find the viscosity test. Okay, when viscosity bath is not available, they are going to use the tar viscometer. Okay, even for the bitumen. But the tar viscometer will be used for the cutback bitumen and emulsion bitumen and the tar, because the cutback bitumen, emulsion bitumen and the tar is in the viscous liquid form, but your general bitumen is in the semi-solid form. Is it clear? Okay, viscosity is the measure of resistance to flow. Is it clear? Okay, and usually the basic principle of viscosity test is to measure the time taken by the bitumen for the flow of 50 mm. Is it clear? Next is float test. The float test is conducted to test the consistency of the bitumen, which is not possible to conduct by viscosity test and penetration test. Means whatever the bitumen, for that bitumen, when it is not possible to conduct the or to know the consistency of the bitumen from penetration test and viscosity test, okay, those type of bitumen will be subjected to float test to know the consistency of the bitumen. Is it clear? Okay. Next is specific gravity test. Okay, usually you are going to use a density bottle, about 50 ml capacity density bottle for conducting the specific gravity test of bitumen. Okay, we all know that the specific gravity of bitumen ranges from 0.98 to 1.03, whereas tar is 1.1 to 1.25. Okay, the specific gravity test is conducted to know the quality and strength of any materials. Also, we can say that the specific gravity test is conducted to know the density of the material. Okay, the density of the bitumen will be obtained from the specific gravity test. Density of the bitumen is obtained from the specific gravity test. Okay, next is flash and fire point. Flash and fire points are the critical temperature at and above which suitable precautions need to be taken. Okay, while heating the bitumen. Is it clear? Both flash and fire point are the critical temperature at and above which you need to take suitable precautions while heating the bitumen. Okay, in your bituminous mix plant or in the site. Because means at the flash point, the flash point is the temperature at which the bitumen having a bluish flame. Usually it's about 220 degrees. Usually the flash point of a bitumen is about 220 degree. Okay, within 4 to 5 degree, about 224 degree, okay, your fire point occurs. Okay, fire point is also a critical temperature at which your bitumen is get ignited. Okay, that's why if you know the flash point and fire point of the temperature, okay, before heating the bitumen in the field. Okay, next is solubility test. Okay, to know the solubility of the bitumen, we're going to conduct the solubility test. Means we know that now the bitumen is completely soluble in the carbon disulfide and carbon tetrachloride, CS2 and CCl4, and whereas your tar is completely soluble in toluene. Okay, then how much quantity the bitumen is soluble in CS2 and CCl4, that we have to measure by using solubility test. Okay, usually the specified value for the solubility test is 99.9%. Okay, 99.9% bitumen has to be soluble in your CS2 and CCl4, then it is a good quality bitumen. Otherwise, we are going to discard the bitumen. Okay. The next is spot test. The spot test is conducted to know the overheated bitumen or to know the cracked bitumen. Is it clear? The spot test is conducted to know the overheated bitumen or cracked bitumen. Okay. Then loss on heating test. Okay. On heating, the volatiles present in the bitumens gets evaporating. Volatiles present in the bitumen gets evaporated. Okay, then the resultant bitumen will be harder in nature. Okay, that is called aging process. That is called aging process of bitumen. Means on heating, how many percentage of volatiles will be lost? On heating, how many percentage of volatiles will be lost? That we have measured by loss on heating test. Okay, next it is water content test. Okay, how much water will be present in the bitumen sample? Okay, that we have measured in the water content test. Usually the maximum limit of water content, it is 0.1%. Okay, above which we want to discard the bitumen. Okay, the maximum unit of water content for the bitumen used in the road construction, that is 0.1% only. Okay, if it exceeds 0.1%, then you are going to discard the bitumen. Okay, this is regarding the binders. Okay,